Hello everyone. As a part of VTU eShikshana program, I am dealing with the application layer of first module of the subject called Computer Networks and Security. Just a takeaway for today's session, I am going to discuss about few topics which I had already explained in the previous session. I think I was explaining about a very important mechanism called email, how email works. Which are three important elements of email servers. One is user agent, one is mail server, and one more called SMTP protocol. Okay, so how the user agent, if you want to communicate with one more user agent, what he has to do, what are the important protocols required, and where SMTP works. SMTP always works between the mail server. If any mail that has to be carried from this mail server to this mail server, SMTP plays a role, and also here also it plays a role. Okay, so I think we discuss about a few aspects of email service. In this lecture, we'll see the detailed aspects of SMTP protocol and other two supported protocols of email. Okay, so right now I have a scenario that A, let me call this as user agent A, or we can call it as client, and we can call this receiver as B, or we can also call this as Alice and this as Bob. Okay, so Alice is going to have his own email address, and Bob is also having his own email address. Okay, whenever Alice wants to send a mail, whenever he wants to send a mail, she has to send a mail to mail server, his own mail server, and that interaction should be happened with the help of SMTP protocol itself. And that interaction that is going to happen between C and S, this client and this server, his own mail server, we'll see in the next slide. Okay, so interaction will always start with the server itself. Why? Because from the beginning of this module, we studied the important architecture of networks. One is client server and one is peer to peer architecture. With respect to client server architecture, we have the scenario that always server should be ready. Okay, client, whenever the client wants to send the request, client can send the request and he'll get the reply. But server should be always ready. That is very, very important. Okay, so here also we are targeting with hamburger.edu. With the help of this edu, we are going to send the data. So with the help of and status code 220, the server should be ready. When the server is ready, the client will send a request message using a command called hello command. He will send a request message to server. Okay, and the server, which server? User client server. We are talking about this server, mail server. We are talking about this mail server. Okay, and whenever the server wants to reply back, he will send a message with the status code 250 with the hello message, pleased to meet you. That is, I mean to say that the server also agrees to connect with the client C. Okay, so the server has to validate whether the client address and the receiver address. So from where it has to send the data? Mail from command. Okay, mail from command with the mail address of Alice. Whenever the server validates the mail address of the Alice from mail from command, and he will send, the sender is okay. Okay, so the client will also send the receiver mail address, that is Bob mail address, and server will validate the Bob mail address, and he'll also send recipient is also okay, sender is also okay. Okay, one, he will validate, whenever the mail server validate both client and receiver mail address, then only he will take the data from the client. Okay, so then he will take the data. The data will be validated. Data will be taken from the client. That is some data, random data we have taken here. And once after sending the taken the data from the client, the server will start sending the data to for delivery. Okay, to where it will send? This will send the data to the receiver mail server. Okay, and again the receiver mail server will forward the data to user agent. Okay, so once after sending, the client will go with the quit connection. Okay, server will also close the connection which has been established with the client. Okay, this is the interaction that is going to happen between client and server in case with the help of SMTP protocol. Okay, so the main intention of this SMTP protocol interaction is the client will never send the data directly to Bob. What it does, he will send the data to mail server and he will indirectly send the data to the respective receiver. Okay, so whatever the mail he want to send, that will not happen directly. Okay, the interaction that is going to happen, these are the interaction with five important messages, which are those hello command, mail from command, receive to command, data command, and quit command. This is five commands that's going to use by SMTP protocol. Okay, and what is the name of the server it's going to use? Telnet server. Okay, with the status code of 20 replay, the server is ready with the five important commands: hello command, mail from command, receive to command, data command, and quit command. Hello command to establish the connection, mail from command to verify the mail address of the sender, receive to command to verify the mail address of the receiver, data command, whatever the data that has to be exchanged between the client and server, and at last, to close the connection, we'll go with the quit command. And now, I think we saw the main important aspect of HTTP protocol in the beginning of this module. Now we'll compare the SMTP protocol with HTTP protocol. Okay, HTTP protocol, we have two flavors. One is 1.0 and one is 1.1, persistent and non-persistent communication. But SMTP have one flavor with persistent connection. This uses pull operation and this SMTP uses push operation. Both SMTP protocol and also HTTP protocol, they'll use ASCII commands. Okay, here we'll use input command, get command, and all. Here also we'll use from command, data command, and so on. SMTP uses CRLF to clear the data. Here also it will use various status code. Okay, SMTP also uses various status code. Okay. SMTP have multiple objects sent in multi-part string, but HTTP, each object is encapsulated in its own response message. These are some of the differences between HTTP protocol and SMTP protocol. Both lies in the application layer. Okay, so once we see the interaction between the client and server, how SMTP protocol message format looks like. SMTP protocol message format consists of two important parts. One is message header and one is message body. I think we saw the mail, as usual, as we sent the mail, we'll get the same headers, correct? No? So in the header, we'll get two from and subject. That is two mail address, from mail address and subject. What is subject of your message? And the body consists of actual ASCII data. Okay, same thing we have in here, the compose. Once you click the compose button, we'll get the data. Same thing we have in the SMTP message format. Okay, along with this SMTP, very important protocol of email servers, we have this email also supported with two important protocols called POP3 and IMAP4. POP3 stands for post office protocol with version number 3. This 3 stands for version, 4 also stands for the version. And one more important protocol called IMAP, Internet Mail Access Protocol. We'll see one by one in this lecture. Okay. As the name itself indicates, post office protocol works similar to the post box or postman. Okay. What's the job of the postman? Whatever the post mail that is collected in the post box, he will take out all the data from the post box and he will segregate the post mails and he will deliver the data to the respective destination. Similarly, post office protocol works in a similar fashion. Okay, wherein which this POP protocol has to be installed both on the client side and also on the server side by default by the server, respective servers. It might be IMAP and POP protocol, they are defaultly installed in the respective servers. Okay, this is a POP3 protocol also have the TCP port number with 110 and it will take the valid username and password. Okay, so once the valid username and password it will take, the mails will be accessed one by one. After entering the valid username and password, you can check out the inbox and you can check out the outbox. Correct? So post office protocol also redirects all the mails that appears in the mail server to receivers based on the importance or hierarchy. Okay. And again, this POP protocol, they have two modes. In the mailbox, we'll receive some mails. We can keep the mails and also we can delete the mails, correct? So we have two modes. One is delete mode and one is keep mode. Delete mode will delete the messages once they are read, and keep mode, they can also retain the mails once they after reading the mail from the mailbox. Okay, POP3 commands has mainly four important commands. One is login, logout, and fetch message, and at last delete message. These are the four important commands you can have in the POP3 protocol. Okay, login with the help of username and password. After composing the mails, we can log out, and it will fetch the data and it also delete the messages. Okay, this is a rough introduction to the details of POP3 protocol. We'll see IMAP features. IMAP features, a user can check the email header before downloading, correct? He will check the user header with the help of subject line. A user can search the contents of the email for specific string prior to downloading. He will never download all the mails or attachments and all. He will check the input and header, and if they are valid, if they feels that it seems to be a valid one, they will download. User can create, delete, and rename mailbox. Create a hierarchy of mailboxes in the folder in email storage, like primary, secondary, and all can be created with the help of very important protocol called IMAP protocol. And along with this IMAP protocol, there is one more supporting mechanism called protocol called as MIME. Okay, MIME protocol will be commonly used especially for multimedia data. Okay, whenever this SMTP protocol will cannot able to transfer the non-text messages, this SMTP protocols, this MIME protocol plays a role. Okay, MIME is not a program that runs on the server, rather than it acts like a translator which sits on the top of the SMTP protocol. Okay, and converts the text mail into equivalent text mail along with the relevant information. It might be audio, video, text, image. All the data will be converted by MIME protocol, which runs on the top of the SMTP protocol. That is a beautiful importance of MIME. Okay, so now I'll show you where exactly mail works. I'll show you that. You can check out here. As we can have here, you can see here. If I click the compose email, it will consist of to, for, and subject. Correct? No? By form will be by default. It will be there. The content you can write and you can close it. This is our about SMTP protocol. And if you go for settings, see all settings. Go for see all settings. And here is an option called forwarding and POP and IMAP. Okay, by default POP protocol and IMAP protocol will be defaultly present in here, any mail server. Okay, so POP is to download the data and IMAP is to check out whether it is valid or header can be checked out with the help of IMAP. With the help of this, we can able to download the relevant files or the mails which are appears in the mailbox. Okay, you can check out this. You can enable POP, you can enable IMAP and respective things. Okay, so I think in this lecture we saw how IMAP protocol works, POP protocol works, what is the use of MIME protocol, and how exactly the interaction between the client and server will happen with the help of SMTP protocol. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening.